Hi everyone, in this video our topic is about cycloid. So first of all, I'll try to explain cycloid in this figure. So imagine there is a circle and it is rolling on a plane or a straight line. Okay, so this point is P. Okay, the point is on the circumference of the circle, and the rolling of the circle is without any slipping. While the circle is rolling on this plane, it should not slip. So in that condition, the point P will be tracing a path. Okay, as the circle is rotating and moving forward, this point P on the circumference of the circle will be tracing a path. So it will be traveling in a path. That path is called as a cycloid curve or cycloidal curve. Okay, so we are going to construct that curve. Okay, so brief definition. So a cycloid is a curve traced by a point on the circumference of a circle which rolls without slipping on a plane. Okay, so this is the circle and this is the point on the circumference. This is the circle and the point on the circumference, and this is the plane on which it will be rolling without slipping. So now this circle which rolls along the straight line is generating circle or rolling circle. So this circle is called as a generating circle or a rolling circle. And the straight line on which the circle rolls is a directing line. So this line is actually acting as a base for the rotation, so it is called as a directing line. Okay, so the concept of cycloid curves are extremely used in designing a gear tooth. So we know that we are having gears in our motor vehicles, so we will be using this cycloidal curve to design the gear teeth. Okay, so we will be seeing a question and we'll be trying to construct it. So this is your question. Construct a cycloidal curve traced by a point on the circumference of a circle of radius 30 mm. Draw a normal and tangent to the curve at any point on it. Okay, the data required is only the radius of the circle. Okay, so with this data we'll start constructing. Now take a compass, and as the radius mentioned in the question is 30 mm, with the scale and compass take 30 mm on the compass, and with some convenient point draw a circle with 30 mm radius. Okay, mark the center point of the circle as C. Okay, now after that what you have to do is you have to divide the circle into even number of parts. You can divide it into 8 parts or you can divide it into 12 parts. Okay, so I am going to divide this into 12 parts. Okay, take your drafter and draw a horizontal line in the circle and a vertical line. So it will be coming into 4 parts. Now the remaining 12 parts you have to take. So to get 12 parts, what you have to do is you have to mark every point for every 30 degrees, and this side also, this is 30 and this is 60. Okay, same way in this side. Okay, so we have divided our circle into 12 equal parts. After that what you have to do is give the numbering in the anti-clockwise direction. So this point will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. Okay, so as the circle will be moving in this direction, this point will be touching first, this will be 2, this will be 3rd. So in this fashion, so we will be tracing the path of this point. Okay, Now use a drafter and from this point, from the 12th point, draw a horizontal line. Check that this line is horizontal to this 3-9 line, and then use the drafter and draw a horizontal line that will be a PA. So the length of this horizontal line should be equal to the circumference of this circle. So the length should be equal to 2 pi r, that is equal to 2 into pi into 30. 30 is the radius of the circle. This value will be equal to 188.49. So what I'm doing is I'm going to draw a horizontal line. The length is 188, that is 188.49 implies 18.8 centimeters. Yeah, so this is the end point. Okay, so mark this point. The 12th point will be your P and this end point is your A. Okay, after that you have to divide the PA line also equal to this number of parts. You have divided the circle into 12 parts, so divide the PA line into 12 parts. So dividing the line into equal parts method, you will be doing, take a acute line of convenient length and take your compass and draw 12 arcs of same radius on this. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Okay, so give the numbering. This will be a 1-2-3-4-5-6-7-8-9-10-11-12. Okay, after giving the numbering, what you have to do is you have to join 12-2A. Okay, 12-A. Join these 2 points and lock your drafter and draw a line. Okay, now with this you have to obtain all the points. Give the numbering. This will be a 1-2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and A will be your 12. Okay, so after that what you have to do is you have to complete the rectangle with these dimensions. Okay, so let's see how to draw that. From 6 also draw a horizontal line equal to 18.8 and join these 2 points. Okay, this point will be B and the rectangle is P, A, B and 6. So after that what you have to do is you have to draw the horizontal lines from the points. So join 1 and 11 and draw a horizontal line. 2 and 10 will be giving the other horizontal line. Next, 3 and 9, extend it. That is the center line. Next, 8 and 4 also. And 7 and 5 is the next. Okay. So, after drawing the horizontal lines from the circle, you have to draw the vertical lines from these points. Okay. These points you can draw up to the top. Okay, so after that you have to mark the points where the this perpendicular lines are meeting the 3-9 line. This is the 3 and 9 line. So what you'll be doing is this one line is marking the line from the point 1 is cutting the 3-9 line at this point. So this will be C1, so this will be your C2 point, this will be your C3, this will be your C4, C5, C6, C7, C8, C9, C10, C11, C12. So basically you are tracking the position of the center while it is rotating and moving forward. Okay. So now after that we have to use our compass and take 30 mm as radius. So this is the 30 mm radius. First we have drawn with 30 mm. Or use the scale to get it. Okay, now with the center as a C1, okay, with the center as a C1, cut this line first, the one line, the line, the horizontal line which is passing from 11 and 1. So you will be drawing a line. That point where it is intersecting the horizontal line will be your, this point will be your P1. Okay, now with C2 you have to cut the second horizontal line. So it is this point here, that will be your P2. Now with the same radius, the 3 as center, C3 as center, cut the third line. This is the point, that point will be your P3. Okay, now with the C4 as center you have to cut the fourth line. With 5 as center you have to cut the fifth horizontal line. C6, this point will be exactly intersecting. C7, the seventh line here. Let me mark the points. See, this is P3. P4. This is P4. This point will be P5. This is P6. And this is your P7. And next with C8. C8, you have to cut the 8th line. This is your 8th line. This is your P8. And this is your 9th one. So this is your P9. 10th. So this is the 10th line here. P10. And C11 you have to take, and you get the this point as P11. And this is all this is 12 again. So now you have got your points. Join them as P, P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, P6, P7, P8, P9, P10, P11 and 12. Okay, this is your full cycloid. This curve is full your cycloid. So after that, we have to draw the tangent and normal. So choose a point on the cycloid. This is the point where I am going to draw. That point is M. So with the same 30 mm radius, take point from the M. You have to cut the center line. So that point will be your C again. Imagine that as some Q. Okay, this point is some Q. You have marked a point M on the circle of that curve. From there, with 30 mm radius, that is equal to the radius of the circle, you will be drawing a curve on the center line. That point is Q. Now what you have to do is you have to take your drafter, and from Q you have to draw a vertical line onto PA. So this point will be your D. Okay, so now what you have to do is you have to join M and D. You have to join M and D. So that line will be your normal. Okay, now lock it and draw a perpendicular line from this point to the normal. This line will be your tangent. So this is your normal and this is your tangent. Okay, so the radius of the length of PA is equal to 2 pi r. Okay, I am writing it here, 2 pi r. Or you can write 2 pi r, that is equal to 188.49 or 188.5. Okay, so this is how you draw your cycloid and it's a tangent and normal. So that's all.